All right, so I'm 21. I'm in my fourth year of getting my mechanical engineering degree. I've got one more year left. I do very well in school. I think my biggest, my engineering mind has always been, I like to be able to plan things out ahead of time. And that's usually how I make the best designs and how I do well in my job and things like that. The struggle I face now is typically, I don't know if I know enough of what I want to exactly know. So it's really hard for me to plan because I don't know if I know enough of what direction I go. I know I love doing like and creating things and designing and engineering and getting down technical and stuff like that. But I sometimes find myself paralyzed because I can't, I worry about spending too much time and then discovering, oh, this wasn't what I wanted to do. And then I fear, but also, then I also fear not doing anything at all.
Yep.
And then I fear kind of almost like fear of missing out too. And it's like, should I be doing? So there's like, I've got a lot of things going for me. I won't have any debt when I graduate. My college is pretty much
good.
Completely covered. So I have a lot of, I know I have a lot of potential, but that kind of stresses me out a little bit because then it's like, I don't want to blow it. Like I know I'm young right now and I know I have a lot of potential. I'm about to lose my video. Sorry. I know I have a lot of ways I could go. I'm worried about kind of screwing it up in a way.
Okay.
Does that kind of make sense?
Yeah. I get exactly where you're coming from here. So good news is I have a really, really simple, easy answer for you. So first of all, I'm going to say, read a book by Cal Newport. It's called So Good They Can't Ignore You. It's all about whether you should follow your passion or not. Short answer, no, do not follow your passion. Okay. But it's got some really salient points in there that address exactly the kind of question that you're asking here. And I'll kind of give you my version of my answer, which is,
okay.
It's two things. I'll lay a framework here, which is this. I have a real rule called the 5-year rule, okay? What it means is that anything you want to become good at, right, that you want to achieve success at, minimum 5-year commitment, right? And so you can almost divide your life up into 5-year blocks, okay? Sure. You want to become good with girls? 5 years, buddy. You want to build a business? 5 years. You want to get awesome physique? 5 years. Okay. Now it doesn't mean that you won't have any level of success in 2 or 3 years. A lot of times you're going to have it, but you have to be willing to commit to something for 5 years. See, the problem, the reason why most people waste their whole fucking life is because they won't ever commit to for a long enough period of time, because just about anything you choose in life, you can be successful at if you're willing to commit 100%. Committing is like the key to life. If you commit, you're going to be successful, but most people don't stick it. They don't commit long enough. So here's what I would say, okay? It doesn't matter what you pick, all right? Mm-hmm. Because of a couple of things. One of them, and probably the most important thing, is whatever that you pick, all right? It doesn't matter if it's the thing that you love in the world, okay? Believe me, I lived in a fucking cubicle, okay? And I had to work for someone else, and I've had some miserable job position. And I remember in the cubicle thinking, wouldn't it be so great if I could just write blog posts for a living and I didn't have to work for someone else? Wouldn't that be awesome? And then, you know, and then I started doing that. Right. And then I was like, oh, what if I could just make YouTube videos? If I could just have enough of a popular YouTube video, I could just make videos and just talk about my opinions all day, or maybe coach people for $1,000, $1,500 an hour. And that would be great. And there are literally days that I wake up and I'm like, oh, damn it, I don't want to make a video. I don't want to get on the phone and have someone pay me $1,500 to talk to them for an hour. I don't feel like doing that. And I'm like, are you fucking mental, John? What the fuck is wrong with you? And the answer is, no, there's nothing wrong with us. The answer is that no matter what you do, okay, if you're a fucking porn star, right? You, one day you're going to wake up, like, it's going to be great. You're a porn star, right? You're like, oh, this life is great. It's awesome. You know, all I do is fuck. That's it. And then one day you're going to wake up and you're going to be like, fuck, I do not feel like going into work today. Oh man, do I really have to fuck these girls today? Like that, I guarantee you that would happen. I guarantee you that's the truth. Okay. I know this. So the reason why I'm saying that is because it doesn't, there's no magic thing that you're going to do. Okay. You just need to pick something. And what happens is that you will develop, you will bring the passion. And as you become skilled at a thing, it will bring you something better than joy, which is fulfillment. Because as you are, you know, any musician will tell you, you know, this truth of it, or highly skilled athlete, you know, anyone who's really skilled at their job. So don't worry so much about picking the right thing. Just pick something. And then the second part of this is this. So what if you fail? Because see, if your whole goal, if your whole setup in life is I need to pick the right thing so I can, like, you know, go to school, get good grades, you know, get a good job, put money in my 401k, and, you know, and do all these check how you're supposed to live your life, then you're going to be playing it way too fucking safe. Because what your goal should be is I want to grow as much as possible. And that is going to require a lot of failure. Okay. You're going to have to be sacrificed on a cross. You're going to have to go through some pain and some suffering in order to grow. So be willing to, like, be like, fuck, I need to start failing now. Like, I want to go and do some shit and I want to, like, fuck up. I want to fail big time so that I can learn and grow and develop myself, because that's the ultimate thing that you're going to have. Because, you know, most people, even starting businesses, right? Probably you're going to fail at your first fucking business. Okay. But maybe your second one you'll be better at, and your third one. And then at some point, if you keep on failing, you're going to succeed. So I don't know. Those are the two things I would look at there. And I would just say, most important, you know, bottom line is this: just pick something, just go fucking all into it. Keep your focus on the one thing as much as possible. And even when you don't feel like doing it, you know, learn to work without motivation and just keep on going. And that's where the rewards are. It's on that other side of the barrier of motivation. Cause you will hit the motivation hill.
Yep.
Right. Right. And I feel like, you know, I guess I already feel kind of old. I know I'm not.
Yeah, what are you, 21, 22?
Yeah, you're so old. Fucking old man.
I feel like I don't have enough time to take those risks, and maybe that's just, I don't know. I probably shouldn't feel that way.
You're completely wrong. Just know that and start internalizing that you're fucking super young.
Yeah.
Okay.
And it doesn't matter, because, again, all right, the reason why you're afraid to take risks is this, is because you're using someone else's definition of success, the world's definition of success, of value. You're using, I mean, in some way, you're looking for external validation, right? Because if you were a kid, fucking 7 years old, you would just, like, do whatever you wanted in life. Like you wouldn't give a fuck if someone likes, you know, what you're coloring, or what you want to be, a fireman or whatever these things are. You see what I'm saying? Like, you wouldn't care, but you're caring now because you think there's something you're supposed to do, or you think you're going to get marked or some grades on whether or not you're successful, or you're a successful person in life. Ultimately, when you're lying on your deathbed, right? You know, people, they did this thing and they're like, oh, what do people, they say, I would have wanted to spend more time with family. Yeah, they're bullshit. The reason why they're saying that is because their family's right the fuck there. What they really want is they wanted to fucking take more chances in life and to feel like they lived their life fully, right? Even if you fucking fail, right? If you go after something hard and you take the risks and you push yourself and you did what you felt was right in life, not the safe path, but what you felt was right in life, maybe you'll be broke. Fuck it. I don't care. But you will feel like you lived your life. You're only going to get one shot at this. So take the chances. Right. It doesn't matter. If you fuck up, so what? There is no such thing. There's no such thing as failure. Failure with a capital F is only when you give up.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, thank you. Yeah. I appreciate it.
Good stuff. Awesome.